right there.
Who doesn't like a fine mount?
Okay, into the drop! Here we go! And it's time for game two of Vertigo versus Vega!
Do they want Invoker?
And
no, okay.
We are in draft number two. We have an Invoker and a Nature's Prophet, and they actually go very fast after the first few bans here. We have, in terms of differences, none!
Beastmaster, let's go,
in
Vega!
In terms of bans. Still Bounty Hunter and Lone Druid banned out by VP. Still Chen and Earth Spirit banned out by Vega.
Nobody wants Enchantress.
And
yet.
Still OD. Hey, actually, OD and Nature's Prophet. This is the same one, but then swapped around. So yeah. Last game we had Virtus Pro pick Invoker first, and Virtus Pro.
No.
Yeah,
they look like this combination in general is ridiculous. Just having Roar, Sunstrike, and Necrobooks, you can solo kill anyone on the map with Beastmaster.
This is already just a much stronger opening from Vega. Having an offlaner that can get things done, that doesn't need help, in fact, creates a lot of space for the team. And like you said, great setup once you get level 6 for the Sunstrike.
Yeah.
So I like this a lot better for Vega.
I think VP go for a similar kind of thing, though. They pick the healer. Maybe. They could go for a treant, actually. This could be a treant game for
VP. This is going to be a pub pick. This is going to be an Omni OD. Watch it. It's great against
look
the
at
Invoker. Respect ban Drow.
Vega banning the Drow.
They're spooked.
You, gotta do, you do not see that hero banned very often.
Well, after last game.
So guys, we got to ban
Drow this game.
Yeah.
That's when you know you got punished.
Yeah, well.
No. The Brood Mother bond.
No Broody? Oh my god. Pick
here it is.
Alright, in case you guys don't know, Vega, one of the best Brood players in the world on their team. Incredible. Please show me the
my
show
but
me Brood.
But Matt plays Beastmaster.
Yeah, he does, yeah.
I don't care.
They can play support
if they
Beastmaster.
Get Brood, he'll play okay. Brood. Alright? Anyone can play Beastmaster. It's not hard. Okay? He's in control of a hawk and a pig. How hard can that be?
Well, there's sometimes two hawks and two pigs.
That is a little bit more difficult. Oh my god, the forgotten hero, Shadow Man, calling it. No one has picked Jug. We've seen like one Jug pick in the entirety of Dream League, and he's finally picked up again. As you guys were talking about before, you know, not too bad against Invoker. Hard laning Sage, but you can't kill him too easy, and he can fight, which is what these guys need to do.
Maybe the safe later this game, we'll see how they look to set things up here. With the Enchantress getting banned out, Vega aren't going to have the, and the Chen already banned, it's, they can't put that much pressure on the OD, and the Nature's Prophet is on the VP side, so.
Yep.
VP's cores are going to have a really good start here, it looks like.
I think they go offensive with Juggernaut usually, Virtus Pro.
What kind of lane would you, what kind of supports would you like to see?
Witch Doctor was banned.
Yeah, Venge is still in, but picked. Just got picked up, yeah.
Okay, so then,
I'm not sure they're going to go offensive, to be honest. You can, with the Nature's Prophet, give it the safe lane, but Beastmaster's going to have a really good time then.
I think they go all in on the healing, and they just push early. They have their dry side, they can take Roshan really easily.
Witch Doctor's already removed, though.
I think they could go Treant Protector. It's actually...
Warlock. Let's see EGM Warlock.
I was going to say, I almost want to see a Crystal Maiden in this
Crystal
draft.
Maiden's pretty good.
We see the
aura is kind of pointless if you have OD.
He's pretty burstable
well,
here.
Well, for the lane, it's actually quite good.
The big thing I like to see from VP, though, is control around the pit. They do not have much in the way of vision right now. Just Treants does not match the Hawk or the Invoker or the Venge. Vega have all the vision heroes, so you look at this draft, you're talking about wanting to push and take Roshan, you need vision to do
Oracle
that.
Oracle could work, actually, for Shadow Demon.
They go total 180. Good against Roar. You just disrupt someone gets Roar, just disrupt that target.
Yeah, we've seen Shadow Demon picked up once before in this 30. It was picked up with an Invoker for some amazing Sunstrike damage. I mean, it was basically an insta kill.
It's ludicrous.
But this
actually.
Is a really forgotten hero.
Is this a Mirana game?
Could be. I mean,
they must have something in mind with the disruption because right now it's great against Roar. Can dodge a Sunstrike with it.
But you already have like that control with Astral Imprisonment in terms of dodging things.
Well, if you think about it, right.
You mentioned Mirana. Honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if they're considering it.
If you look at Vega's lineup, like Invoker, Beastmaster, Venge, they all have like insane single target damage, like burst damage, and especially early game, Invoker has like 3 spells. If you just like blow all of that on a hero after you roar them, they just disrupt them. All of a sudden, you don't really have much.
Yeah.
So they need like continuous damage, like
So you guys think that they'll be using this Shadow Demon as a setup hero, or I mean?
Well, it's good with Jogan Lane. You can set up for the spin. If you go offensive,
it'd be sick to see some kind of Kunkka.
Not only
roaming
that, you can have
Shadow
Nature's Prophet teleporting in that time as well. Yeah. So it's great, for positioning also from far away. And
you also have the Astral Imprisonment as well to protect.
Whoa!
Nice call, Shane. Nice call.
Look at you.
Yeah, they want to be able to fight relatively early around the pit. Great hero for it.
The spread damage is really good against pushes as well. And you can fight...
I think VP might have something greedy in mind here.
The problem is, though, a lot of Gyro's damage is magical, you know, early game. So having Juggernaut offensive, it's really, really easy, actually. You just spin at him.
We're going old school.
So is this a 4 position...
Lina.
Yes. Think Lina?
Yeah, yes. Definitely. Yep.
Roaming with the Shadow Demon for
Shadow
the setup
Demon,
kills.
Lina. Hello, 2013.
Woo!
Okay,
supports to some FY and Fenrir stuff.
Right? All right. Yeah. Could it work, though, is the question. Will this be able to work out, the Shadow Demon Lina combo?
You know what I'm worried for? Mm. In terms of dire advantage, they do not have a great lineup for taking Roshan.
Who?
Virtus Pro, you got
but
the healing
ward,
that's
amazing.
Nice.
Astral, like, the OD just destroys Roshan. They have healing ward. They have, like, they actually have,
Vega are really good at fighting at Rosh, though. This is not, like, an easy Rosh game.
And Vega has got good tools to take Roshan as well with the Vengeance and the Invoker there. I kind of feel like it's a 50-50, while I feel like it should
I still think Brood could be in the pick. If they pick Beastmaster as a support.
Don't do this to me.
They're
don't put
thinking
my
about
hopes
it.
Up
Lina's
like
good
this.
Against the babies.
Show me the babies, Burro!
No, Lina will kill your babies.
Oh, yeah.
That will not be a Broodmother.
Like, later in the game, yeah, but early game, she just pressures.
Baby side is half the fun of Broodmother. Come on, baby! Show me the... Small me the spider! Oh, the little... Oh, the arachnid assailant! Come
well.
On! Happening. The arachnid assailant!
They could go back for something safer, though.
Please, just pick it! Yeah. Okay, what are we thinking, boys? LB?
I mean, Dazzle could work too.
Darkseer comes to mind if they would just want to be able to team fight around the pit. Could run the Beastmaster as that 4 position still. Probably like a slightly less risky option, but I think it is a good Brood game.
Oh my god! Yes!
I'd like a support.
Yeah,
I think Beastmaster is really good in the offlane.
Wow.
They're gonna play it safe.
And I almost
actually...
wanted to say Earthshaker, but I was more thinking almost Sand King.
Alright, so Shadow Demon runs up. Does a disruption, and Lina's about to do her stone on top of it,
and then
Airchecker just interrupts it. Yeah, it's very good.
Very good. Oh, but is it good enough for them to win, Shane?
No,
what
I love
thinking?
Lina, Shadow Demon is like...
You're going VP?
Crazy, yeah. Good.
Okay, Shane's going Virtus Pro. LD, what's your favor?
No way. Vega have the Beastmaster. They have the better team fight lineup for me overall. I think Shadow Demon Lina is very risky for lane stage. If they don't get much done with that combo early to mid game, then they're just not going to have an impact in team fights.
What do you think?
Oh yeah, there's a reason people don't pick those crappy heroes anymore. I'm going to go with Vega 200%.
Shane, I'll be in your side. We'll see if Virtus Pro can 2-0 this.
Let's
Virtus
go.
Pro almost needs to 2-0 this if you're going to assume that they're going to have a tougher time against Na'Vi because they need to win 3 out of their 4 games today if they want to make it to LAN finals or at least be comfortable to be in that top 3 of the 8 in league play. Let's find out though. Game number 2, it is going to be Vega versus Virtus Pro with Odie Pixel and Draskull.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back at D for Game 2, Vega Squadron versus Virtus Pro. I'm Odie Pixel, I'm joined by Draskull, and the game is underway. Let's get ourselves into it. And Andy, bit of a switch up this time. This time, VP are going to be the ones with that big old powerhouse of OD under their hands. G's going to be the man playing it. And elsewhere across the board, they were talking about the potential of a Brood off an offlaner having the Beastmaster as a support, but it indeed is going to be Mag once again on one of his signature heroes on the offlane. And they do decide to opt for that last pick, Earthshaker.
It's a little bit unconventional, but so are heroes like Shadow Demon. So I think the pick Shadow Demon is really nice against stuff like, you know, Beastmaster, where we were talking about the counters for that. So they obviously took Venge themselves, Vega, so you're left with a Shadow Demon. They go for that option. The Lina Shadow Demon roam, something we haven't seen for a very long time, mostly because nowadays you can't really commit two supports to just walking around the map anymore. It's just not really that efficient in the way that the current state of Dota is played. So it'll be interesting to see how they decide to Lina, as right now it looks like, you know, he's going to make his way towards bottom, no fear. And the other thing, too, to worry about if you're Vega is that even if a Shadow Demon is there and it's just one other hero, you always have to worry about FNG's teleports on top of that as well. You can get, you know, a spin on maybe a disruption if you get lucky. And that hero, more often than not, will be dead unless the Fissure, as the analysts were saying, lands perfectly. So it's going to be a little bit scary for Vega here in this early game. And they do themselves have a tri-lane. So Blast from, like, 2 years ago, tri-lane versus tri-lane. Offlaner versus offlaner.
It really is. It is something that we're not that used to seeing as much as indeed as you said as we used to in Dota 2. I mean, this top lane matchup. So Mag On his Beastmaster against FNG's Nature's Prophet, I mean, I'm already just seeing this. This is surely going to be a hard lane for FNG, because Mac, he knows how to play this position.
It can be a little bit rough, especially if the Beastmaster gets an early stout, which he's already picked up. But at the end of the day, we talk about the movement through the lanes and how much pressure VP can apply in that safe lane of Vega. You know, FNG wants a TP behind the tower. He can tank the tower with a Nature's Call, and then they can dive, go for a kill. You get a spin going, you get a light strike, a rate of follow-up, a disruption, and there's not really much that Vega are going to be able to do if the combo actually is successful. But it's going to be... I don't know, it's going to be interesting because we don't really see Try versus Try much anymore. And Gyrocopter versus Juggernaut, I kind of have to give a thumbs up to the Jug. It's always been a nice matchup for him because the magic damage doesn't mean anything to you. You just spin it off. During mid-game, if you get a nicely placed Omni, you just kill the Gyro anyway. And that's in conjunction with things like Soul Catcher on top of that, which just amplify the amount of damage that you're going to be taking from the Omni in the first place, so...
No, and I do just want to bring attention really to this mid lane. I mean, we know that OD's going to have a strong lane against Invoker, but G's just played this perfectly. I mean, look at this. He's 8-6 against the 1-1. He's letting no one pretty much get nothing in this lane. I mean, G's OD has been absolutely bang on in these first 2 minutes. The laning, the control, it's been absolutely all there.
Everyone who's ever played with G says, like, mechanically, he's one of the best players they've ever seen. Like, he's actually just insane. And he's been that way for who knows how many years, 5 or 6 years, however long Dota 2 has been out. And even before that, he was still considered to be very good. So no real shocker that he's kind of stepping it up. You could also say that no one could be experiencing a little bit of tilt from game one.
Look at this. 2 minutes in, Invis Rune Gank on the top lane coming in from your Gyrocopter. No one. Jumping a Sunstrike to find that.
Who would have seen that one coming, honestly?
I don't think anyone would have. I don't think FN did. I think he didn't even know what he was doing there himself. He's like, I'm here with an Invis Rune, 2 minutes in. What the hell is happening? Is this even Dota 2? But he gets themselves the first blood. So.
It's a needed rotation as well, because they can't lane the Gyro against the aggressive lane of VP, because again, if you get disrupted, you're kind of just dead. So it's a nice move, ends up netting them the first blood. FNG going to be a little bit sad about that one, as Mag is going to be forced into the jungle now, but he's already almost level 5. So I think the Gyro versus Nature's Prophet should still favor FNG slightly for the time being. But it's more just about getting the Gyro some EXP, because if you can get him a quicker 6, get the cooldown ready to go, then you can start kind of pressuring in your own way rather than letting VP dictate their own tempo.
Oh, this could be very nasty for the Invoker as well. A lower chance of no fit coming in over a rotation. We've already said how no one's been struggling in a nice placement of the Forge Spirit there. We'll scout that out. So no one won't be caught out this time, and he should be fine for the time being. So the gank will be unsuccessful. And I mean, if that gank was successful, that would have been a real kicker for this Invoker. He's already having a pretty tough time against the OD. Bottom lane, Yoku. The play fearing himself away from a bit of aggression that Solo and Shermer were trying to bring out. And getting a bit of farm now on the Shaker here, as of course with these lane switch around. So all in all, the efficiency is certainly going to be there with Vega spreading their heroes across the map now.
Yeah, that's one of the other reasons why we see Shadow Demon so little nowadays, is he kind of needs a secondary hero to be useful. And if the secondary hero is not around, you just don't do anything. And Solo throwing out a defensive Fissure, just going to try to TP it off.
TP, it's a nice one.
Not envisioned there.
And the Slayer himself, he should be able to juke this one out by the looks of it, and he will. Too far away for the risk of a light strike to come through. So very nicely played there from Vega, avoiding once again this action, which, as you said, is taking the resources of two heroes each and every time. Top lane, FNG with the micro, trying to look for the block, but FN just a little bit too speedy with those phase boots. Does manage to get himself away in time.
He's still forcing the Gyro back, though, which is really nice. And also getting himself close to level 6, get that Nature's Wrath going, add that on top of the Shadow Demon combo with the Soul Catcher. I'm not sure if he's going to go 1-1-1 or if he's going to decide to level Soul Catcher. It kind of depends on the lineup, but the Soul Catcher Lina combination
is really powerful.
He's just going to go for the poison. It's just an extremely good value point, even if you decide not to max it. Grant's Vision still does a pretty reasonable amount of damage at level 1 if you get a good amount of stacks. And plus you can use it to farm the jungle if you get to a stage in the game where you feel like you can play a little more greedy.
And I like this as well. You got the Lina hanging around mid. G knows if he hits an Astral, it should be a surefire kill set of the Light Strike Array. But no one is playing it good with at the moment. He's holding back. G, will he get the chance to get an Astral? Is he going to go for it? Lina's actually going to go and check elsewhere. Actually looking for the wraparound, but that is going to be spotted out by the ward. So
he got the disruption or the imprisonment. But...
Lina too far away now. So, it'll be unsuccessful and no one. playing it well, just keeping himself safe, making sure to not give up anything more. Now he's actually got the one, being the one with friends coming into the mid lane. Mac and Shemmer smoked up and they've got a roar. Drops it straight away onto GM with the Sunstrike Magic Missile. It's a beautiful and very, very smooth rotation and gank there from the two of them, smoking up as soon as Six comes out on the Beastmaster, and that's the kind of kill you need to be getting. Shutting down G, who's already having a very, very nice time in the mid lane on his OD.
Yeah, that's when you want the Shadow Demon to be kind of camping your mid when those supports are off the map. And it's a bit harder to keep tabs on Mag since he's been in the jungle for quite a long time. And the warding that VP have, it is kind of around mid, but the angle they came from, the wards don't scout it until much, much later. So a little unfortunate for them. And no one going to be quite happy that he's managed to get the two kills on the board. Obviously got the first blood with a Sunstrike and then getting a kill on a G. A little bit of revenge here from game one. Going to have a quick pause. And a nice start from Vega. The nice thing is, you know, they got their Invoker catching up a bit, but Invoker and Gyro are still a little bit behind in regards to overall CS. But the kills, I think, for the Invoker kind of supplement that fact. It's the Gyro, I think, who is having the biggest issue in this early game. But he is approaching level 6. Talked about that timing, and before that, VP are going to decide to push the safe lane tier 1.
Try and get some of these objectives indeed. Yeah, without the 6 on the jar, as you said, there's not really too much they can do, Vega, in terms of trying to hold back against this advance from VP, so they're going to have to let the tier 1 go. Same time, mid lane pings are coming through. We're going to see the both Solo and Invoker hanging around, just seeing if they could catch out G with the Fisher, but the follow-up wasn't there in time, so G's going to be fine for the time being. And we'll see where VP decide to push next. At the same time, we'll see where Vega go with this smoke.
They are smoking on roar cooldown, quite literally. There's like 2 seconds left when we clicked on G there. So
can they get this as a courier as well, though?
You can roar the courier too if you want to.
It can if you want. See what the play is here. It's going to walk straight over them. They're going to decide to just look for the kill instead. They'll get the vision with the wave straight in. They don't even need the roar for this one.
I actually think killing the courier is more valuable than killing Aloha Dance, to be honest. But if they turn it into a tower, then obviously it's worth. But I think the cooldown on respawn is just so low that they might not be able to kill this tower without being contested. We'll see though if AP want to try to defend.
Right, Yoku, pumping very aggressively here on the bottom lane. It's level 7 at the moment, and we'll start to get himself out of their top lane. FNG and Nofear coming in with the defense, and yeah, looks like Vega are going to hold that off for the time being. No one attacking around.
I think Mag actually cancel cast his roar because the smoke broke, and maybe he was assuming that the kill would be more valuable than the courier, but it's a hard decision to make in a snap, you know what I mean?
It is, yeah, especially if there's more heroes there. It's like, coming dude, in from behind. You blew the roar on the courier, we needed it for the fight, and talking about the fight, Solo. Astral into the light strike, the combo's there. Vega, they look to try and want to do something in return. They've got a roar, they do have a cooldown coming around here towards the mid lane cooldown. It's going to clip onto two, the Sunstrike on the G as well. That's the OD
nice
down, but the Omni coming in from Yoku will punish the aggression from the Gyrocopter. Now, maybe see if they can move in for more. Blade Fury onto Mag, but Mag around the tanky here, but the Sprout holding Blade already gets it. FNG takes down Mag on the Beastmaster, low on up, Fisher to the backside. He's gone, it's a 2-for-2 at the moment. Can they get more? Yoku's still there, should be able to find the Venge. Will do, it's a double kill for FNG though, who now sprouts up solo, and FNG looks to maybe find himself a triple, and he will! Triple kill for FNG on his Nature's Prophet. Great play from the man. He's been receiving a lot of flack online for his performance on the offlane, and a bit of flack there from the Gyrocopter, but he's just done it there without triple. Great play and great presence from the team as a whole, and personally, FNG himself.
FN was just a little bit too far out of position there. Diving too deep for the kill, ends up getting a solo Omni to the face with his team just a little bit out of range of being able to split that. If the Omni doesn't kill Gyro, I think that Vega probably end up winning that fight pretty handedly. So FN, overextension, not the greatest. They end up getting a couple of bonus picks
and
here.
FNG, he's not done.
With
that Sunstrike hit, that man was a dead man. FNG tried for the TP out and will just make it. The question is, can VP turn
what
this into a kill onto no one?
That was sick, actually.
Sick!
That was a really good ice wall, man. To be honest, when you're playing Exodus Invoker, your only real escape mechanism is ice wall. Because your ghost walk
really is
crap, because you can't move very fast, because you only have 1 point Wex usually in the early game.
Yeah, kind of moving
and
in
he
reverse.
Has none, so he can't even use ice wall. Can't even use Ghost Walk, but yeah. It's actually much harder to position those than you would think.
No. Well, 5-5 at the moment, 10 minutes in. It's certainly panning out to be a bit of a tighter one than game one, at least. No one really swinging away
yeah,
massively,
that's...
but it is a slight edge for VP, I want to say, really, at the moment.
Yeah, a little bit, but it can swing either way very quickly, and I think that Vega probably have the advantage in terms of overall team fight.
I mean, I'm just looking really kind of the difference between Yoku and the Gyro.
I guess so, but the Gyro has a much easier time in fights making his spells be very effective and just the amount of damage that he does, because Juggernaut is most likely not going to get like this 3 or 4 man spin where your cooldown can very easily hit 3 or 4 heroes. Your flat cannon's going to be hitting everyone because it's 1,000 radius. So it's a lot easier for the Gyro to be impactful, I think.
And it's the classic combo. SD and Lina having some fun in the jungle. They'll take down Shoma, but Mag is there with the rebuttal. We're on to Lord Dux. That's going to be one kill. Can they find themselves more? In fact, Mag. Oh, that Fisher! Just done it there, saving the man, but FNG will punish the Shaker. They do manage to get Mag out though. Shaker giving his life. And it's still good for VP. It really, really is. 7-6 at this point. The push coming in from no one on the mid lane with the Forge Spritz. Odie is there. Cold Snap will hold him at bay and keep him at bay there.
That's a pretty interesting game so far. A lot of heroes we don't see a whole lot of. Shadow Demon, Earthshaker. Oh, good swap.
Is it going to result in a kill? Well, the FNG Sprout certainly will. Sprout from FNG, Fisher onto two, no one. Thinking about turning around, see if we can find something. Gets the cold snap onto a lower dance, but lower dance now turning back in. As it is G on the OD, just forced the back top. Yoku's got blade through just in time coming off. If he didn't have that, that would have been a dead man, and he may just be anyway. Mag chasing it down. The Fisher coming through Yoku. Just the tip of the Astral to save, and the turnaround, Laguna Blade, Mag's punished. Sunstrike, Yoku! Oh, Yoku! Juking out these Sunstrikes.
The awareness, man, he knows.
Oh my god, I think all kind of the every single pro player seems to have got PTSD with the amount of Vokers that they're popping into their pub, because we're seeing so many Dukes of the Sunstrikes these series, Andy.
Yeah, it's one of those things where you play against a hero for so long, you just have like that sixth sense.
Straight line.
Yeah, you do the zigzag, you know, serpentine, it works.
Really smart stuff from the guys. And swap onto FNG. He's been having a good run so far. Looking to be punished in charge. Can they actually get him out? Maybe with the lights, so they can hold Shoma to stay back. FNG, 15 HP, pops out an extra trap. He's going to live.
Oh, we got him.
Getting taken down. Got him indeed. Shadow Demon with a final touch with the poison, and FNG lives.
Man, that's got to feel pretty bad, honestly, if you're Vega. Not getting that kill, end up losing a hero, potentially even losing the tower on top of that. That's going to be pretty painful. As it looks, actually. They're not going to go for it. They don't want to put it in deny range, I guess. I suppose they don't really have, like, Omni Slash or anything on the Juggernaut just yet. And speaking of, Jug going for Battle Fury, a little bit different.
Do you like the old Battle Fury?
I think it's okay in this game because going late as Jug against these types of heroes is fine. A lot of the time, Juggernaut is not seen as, like, the scariest six-slotted hero, but if it's just Gyro and Invoker, I think it's more than okay to go into the ultra late game, especially considering that VP have done a really good job at controlling a laning phase. You know, they've gotten more towers right now. I mean, heck, they haven't even lost a tier one. And we're rolling in on 14 minutes, and they're looking to potentially...
Draw, G, Sunstrike as well. G, can he get himself out of this one? Fairly tanky at the moment with that bit booster. FNG coming in with the TP. Can he block it off with the Sprout? Oh, no, he can't! They still get the kill, and now maybe a couple more. Solo Mag going through, but pops the Echo Sound with FNG, but FNG seeming to be incredibly tanky on the next. Probably not quite tanky enough, though. No one comes in with a Forge Bridge, the right picks, takes him down. It's a double kill for Mag. They'll get the Shadow Demon as well. Lina trying to see if he can find anything here, but there's a Shaker with the Fisher, forcing Lina back, and he's 4 dead on VP. Vega striking back as hard as they can. They'll get a push on the tier 1 as well, and that couldn't have gone any better for the side of Vega there.
Yeah, G was extremely greedy with his Astral. He waited so long because I think that he was expecting the FNG Sprout to save him, but not expecting the Fissure, unfortunately. And Solo with that is going to help secure the kill on him. And after the fact, without your OD alive and your Juggernaut kind of farming mid, you just don't have the tools available to take that fight. And Vega pulling out a very much needed skirmish win there. They do still maintain their tier 1 mid as well. Oh man, that's a dead.
He's not maintaining his life though.
Much dead.
And he's seeing that ancient stack, and he's like, oh, looking forward to the Battle Fury, no one. He's looking forward to a bed of roses.
I don't know if he's looking forward to it, per se, but he's going to be given one regardless.
I mean, how many times is it? How's the Invoker doing in terms of KDA? He's only died once. He's only died the once, though. That was the first step. I was going to say, so far, it seems to have been a pretty clean game from no one. And 3-1-4, especially considering the lane start that he had against G's OD.
Yeah.
He's been played really nicely.
But that's the thing about Invoker is if you're playing Exort, even if you kind of get owned in lane, you can just always come back because you just use Forge Spirits, farm lanes, farm woods.
And Sunstrike here, Sunstrike there.
Yeah.
You get yourself those kills, and VP going for the Roshan. Vega, they are in a position to try and contest it as they make their way over. It's going to go down pretty quickly. They've got to hurry on in if they want to try and do something to stop VP from getting this one. FNG says, you shall not pass, but he gets vicious and swapped in. And the defensive disruption buys some time for the man. Roars and over. He now gets Astral, balls everywhere, saving VP. FNG sprouts up, Shoma holding him on the sidelines. Sunstrike, will it connect? Yes, it does. Laguna Blade comes out, return for a low dive, but it's not enough for the burst. Giant boys, though. Sally is coming through, Mag. Now on a killing spree. G moving forward on Shoma with the stick charges. Keeping the Venge alive, and he's too damn fast. Shoma will get himself out of the sidelines. So Vega losing no one there in that fight. VP, they've lost two. And now, maybe three. G, gonna get disrupted here by the SD. And now Astral, he just wants himself out of this game and into an alternate reality. And he's gonna be able to survive through the burst.
What? Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
I was gonna say, wait, what?
What?
Alrighty, I mean, alrighty.
Yeah, you... What?
That's, I think what he was trying to do is chat wheel well played spam.
Probably.
Because he was dead. Because that's what you do when you die.
It does. Yeah. And angrily ping whoever has the most deaths on your team.
Yes. Obviously. So
makes you feel good.
This is a really strong timing here from VP. They have almost all of their ultimates available except for Sanity's Eclipse. Laguna's up in about 15. They got Omni. Battle Fury's done on Yoku.
Oh, FNG. He's not done at all. He gets himself a sprout to no one. Blasts himself out. Now. VP, they'll return to getting the objective of tier 1. They'll push for more, of course, Aegis on G. They're ready to continue with this one.
This is really scary for Vega. Their Shaker is so close to Blink too. Like, they need to delay this until the Shaker has Blink Dagger, because then with a nicely placed Echo, they could potentially defend.
Solo, 1v1ing FNG up top. Let's see how this pans out. FNG.
Fight me, mate. That's what Solo's saying.
Against the trees.
Right now.
I mean, FNG's just trying to cut him out at the moment. There is a slam. Oh, in the tree line. Sunstrike as well. FNG in trouble. Echo slam to the face, but he's got a mech. He's going to be fine for the top. Oh, it's fine for a TP, but this man, he's got a few stuns up his arms.
Okay.
Oh.
Well, they did trade the tier 2 mid for that, but that was an optimistic TP there from
and
FNG.
That, as you were saying just before that, that's a huge kill because that is the Earthshaker's blink done for the next push.
Well, it was more than just blink. It was like 700 gold for that. He only needed two.
Blink and a rapier.
Yeah. I mean, rapier, yeah, okay, you know, decent.
You know,
I mean, I'm pretty sure you can just, you can actually buy a heart on Shaker, and when you enchant, you get like almost the same amount of damage anyway, because it's base damage.
No, what's the percentage?
It's 400, I think.
400, isn't it?
Yeah, at max level.
Hey, time to fight around the ancients, G. Frontlining a little bit too much, potentially falling down to half Fisher as well. G in a bit of trouble, he does have that Aegis. Cordon coming through as well, but the disruption protecting him from the Cordon. Alardas won't be protected. Roar to the face, he's down. G, turn around with the Arcane Orbs, will take down the Ventral Spirit. FNG, what can he do here? Pops the Nature's Wrath. We'll see if VP moving for more, but they might want to just hold back solo. Still looking for the Fisher, but the Astral, oh G, juking out the Fisher damage. He's going to be fine. There is a Blink available, but Shaker, he won't want to jump into this one at the moment.
He had to solo Echo FNG to kill him, so he's not going to be able to use it here.
And that's pretty big for VP as well. Able to clean up some of those larger ancients. Sunstrike, it's going to be off point. VP will be fine. Still hanging around at the moment. We're going to see FNG leave the fight here, head back to the top to get the push back out. 14 for 13. It is still feeling like a close one, but still the farm for Yoku on his jug reigns supreme as he's close to hitting on 10k at the moment on the Juggernaut.
He's just had a pretty easy game. It's a nice lineup to play Juggernaut against because there's not really many ways they can jump you until there's multiple blinks. So now that Shaker has Blink Echo, that is one way they can go and they can catch out the Juggernaut. So that leaves them open to smoke opportunities for the side of Vega, which would be nice to get some map control back. But in the meantime, we also see a Blink picked up by G, still holding on to his Aegis. That's going to be really nice for Blink saves. So you can put like a Juggernaut in front.
FNG, didn't check the weather forecast. It's meteors raining on the top lane. And no one with a quick and easy pick off there.
It was a very nicely placed meteor because it forced him to walk in one direction. So you can't run to the right, which is towards your base. And he cold snaps in a way that you pretty much eat it.
You got a blink? I got a blink. Alara Dance, has he got the timing down? Yes, he has. Laguna to solo and one slap to the back from G. We'll do it. And there's your carry versus carry action and Yoku. Absolutely destroying the gyrocopter. The old man ripped from his vehicle and chucked to the floor.
That's pretty much why you don't want to play gyro against Juggernaut. That pretty much sums it up right there. And, you know, the fact that you can't deal any damage to him with any of your early game abilities because of Blade Fury.
Yeah, really showing the difference between these two heroes. But Vega, trying to make the best of a bad situation now off the back of losing two.
I don't know, they're going to get forced back here though, because... Oh, actually, Shaker has Blink Echo, so maybe VP just back after this tower. Like, obviously they force a TP, but after that they don't actually want to commit to the push. Committing to a push with Echo being available, that's a level 11 Shaker as well, so it would do a ton of damage if they get caught.
I'm looking forward to this one. That's the Aegis gone, though.
Yeah, they won't push this. This is way too scary. Mag wanted that roar so badly.
So, like, he still wants some action. You can see him smoked up.
Yeah, he's hoping,
I'm gonna give it.
He's hoping that they push so he can get the Echo, and this is common stuff, you know, smoking on the Blink Initiator.
Low hard dance?
I think he's dead.
He's just roasted a Hawk with that Dragon Slave.
Yeah, just bail on him. Good call from VP, letting him just die. No reason to commit to that fight. They didn't have any aggressive vision in that particular area of the jungle anyway, so going for a fight when you don't know where Shaker is, you don't have the Beastmaster committing his roar just yet is way too difficult.
FNG, what's he going for next here, do you reckon? 2.4k on some of the phase, mech.
Hard to say, maybe Maelstrom BKB? That seems to be Maelstrom a very common nice. Buildup. Like, BKB in the team fight makes him more or less invulnerable to a lot of the damage that Vega have.
Oh, Courier. Can Mag reach it? Oh!
Nope. He's trying real hard.
He was trying to roar it there. In fact, he canceled casted it. I think he maybe contemplated it a little bit too late.
Yeah, he has to be able to hit it. Aurora's not going to kill it. Oh, okay. It stuns him, but it doesn't kill it.
He hasn't got Blink yet, hasn't he? No.
I mean, you can cut the trees down one by one and hope that you can get close enough, but...
G? Gonna catch him out here.
He is so fine.
Yeah. And they know it. They're not even going to bother looking their nose out of that. G with the escape. And with a hefty bit of gold as well. I mean...
I think BKBs are just the name of the game right now for Virtus Pro. Like, your Juggernaut already has a built-in magic immunity, that's fine.
Yep.
FNG might make one more farming item before he goes BKB, and then Juggernaut may go one a little bit later on as well. Because he can just spin and hit the tower, right? Like, he doesn't necessarily have to build BKB right now, but it might be on the menu for him at some point.
I think he kind of has to, especially when you look at not only, obviously, all the magical damage they've got already, but the fact that your Shaker is very close to finishing off a Veil on top of the Blink Dagger.
It's going to be painful, man. You get an Echo, you catch like two or three heroes and some trees, you're going to kill somebody straight up. That damage output is no joke.
Hey, BP, wrapping around here, Yoku, he's got an Omni Slash, he's going to look to pick, he'll get fissured, Magic Missed up as well, Solo, has he got the control with the Echo Slash, they might get Yoku, oh, no, he's going to be able to keep himself alive there, the mech coming out, just his own FNG, but he's going to blink himself out, Sunstrike's going to latch up to Yoku, he's still got the Omni Slash, they want to turn, they're going to put them good to blame, but FN gets the BKB off, chases down the leader with the Rocket Barrage, that's going to be two, as G drops as well. Nice response there from Vega. VP coming in very greedily, very aggressively there with the wraparound by the Radiant Ancients, but Vega were ready with the turnaround, and just from the start of the fight, the amount of control they had on that jug to just say, no, Yoku, we're not going to let you kick this one off.
No Omni for you. Get the heck out of here. Almost even killing him with a Sunstrike, and I think by committing that hard and not having vision of the Shaker, it puts you in a position where your supports are forced to come and help you, and that's why G died, right?
Yeah.
Because Aloha Dance was just running in, he's like, I got to save my carry, and then the mid player gets jumped and there's nothing left in the tank to be able to help heal in that regard. So they end up losing a few. Not the best engagement from VP that we've seen so far, but they had a pretty decent looking flank. It just didn't quite work out for them. And with that extra time, you're going to see the Gyro starting to get closer to his next item. He's sitting at 2,500 gold now, so FN maybe looking to...
Nah.
Nah, nothing's gonna happen there, yeah. Maybe looking to get MKB or maybe even go back for the SNY. I feel like they're gonna be lacking some physical damage soon if they don't get like a proper initiation.
Mid lane smokes up, jumping in, they'll get the lead in Astral. VP are ready to bring down the kitchen sink and everything else onto no one, and he's gone. It's a clean one, and this is the man who just went all in on an Aghanim's purchase, so he's down for a full minute. Oh, they actually managed to Astral Man before he TP'd out. Solo held back in this one. He's going to get gotten as well, and so is Ben. This is double kill for G, and suddenly, I mean, that's got to be racks at a minimum. That couldn't have gone any worse for Vega. Three down, no buyback, and VP more than a... in a position to push. They're ready to do some serious damage here to the base.
And this is... It's one of those lineups where you see the potential of a Shadow Demon, what it can actually do. when you're chasing out, having the Soul Catcher, you know, having the Demonic Purge, it just nets you a straight up kill because you can't run away from the Purge. If you try to TP, you're going to get imprisoned or you're going to get disrupted. There's just so many ways for them to chase you down after they already start the fight where you start losing a little bit and they're going to take a lot more than that. So VP playing a very solid game here. Yoku still zero deaths, 25 minutes in, 2400 gold on top of his Mantis style and Battle Fury. And now Shadow Demon's got the Aether Lens. That is so good on Shadow Demon, actually. Like, your disruption range is so far with that.
Yep, and that poison's traveling across the whole map.
Yeah, I mean, you talk about, like, Demonic Purge with a bonus 200 range. You can pretty much use it from in fog, almost. Like, that's how far away you are.
And BKB's done on G as well for the next fight.
Yeah, there's a Maelstrom. Oh, he's going straight Mjolnir? Okay, never mind. He sold the recipe. I was looking at FNG's items. He did opt to go for the Maelstrom. Pretty standard stuff coming out from him, and as we expected, also BKB on G.
Yeah, I mean, do you think you're kind of the sign there from selling that recipe and going back? You think he's just going to get BKB himself first before finishing off Mjolnir?
Yeah, I think BKB is the safest choice, FNG. Because if you think about the timing and the way the game's going, they can time the next Roshan around getting 10-second BKBs on two cores simultaneously with already having the Juggernaut and potentially an Aegis. So that power spike is enormous. It sets up for a very strong push that even a Blink Echo might not be able to turn, assuming the BKBs are popped properly. Or you can just make it so, you know, abuse the healing ward, pressure the map, keep Vega inside of their base for, you know, 6 minutes, give or take. And then you're still getting farther ahead because you're farming more than they are. So it's a very stressful situation right now from Vega, knowing that BKB timing is going to be coming out soon and how weak the Invoker, the Shaker, and the Gyrocopter will become because of that, due to the fact that FN does not have a real damage item. And he's going for the Butterfly, which is still okay. Butterfly is good against the OD. If you can get a couple of dodges in, that's nice. Good against the Juggernaut as well. But I don't know if it's going to be like that one item turn the game. This, however, is really good from Vega. Stealing the Roshan right out from under VP. That was huge. They needed that so badly, and VP were just completely caught off guard by that. Instead of being able to get any counter pushing going, they were kind of just walking around as five. Vega with a very nice move there. Might have just saved them, you know, another 5 or 10 minutes of just constant pressure that VP could otherwise apply, and that helps tremendously. The closer the Gyro gets to a fourth item, the scarier it's going to be for Virtus Pro, because then the Gyro starts to become a damage threat rather than just being that guy who throws down a cooldown inside of a fight and a couple of rocket barrages. So the importance of that Roshan actually can't be stressed enough, the fact that Vega got that.
I mean, getting that as well. If you are Vega, do you then try and look to use the Aegis, or that in itself isn't really
just taking it away?
Just,
it, yeah. I mean, sure, you can go for a smoke if you're feeling that confident. You know, you have Aegis on Gyro, you have a 9-second BKB as well. That can be enough to win you a fight, no doubt. But it just depends on if they want to try to wait for another item on him because he's very close to Butterfly before they go for an engagement. So I think that Vega would be pleased just that they got that Roshan at all. I think they're thinking to themselves, oh, thank God, you know, that was really nice that we didn't get contested. You know, VP weren't even pushing when we got the Roshan, just caught a little bit off guard there.
That's now picked up on Beast Master as well. I mean, Vega, of course, we do know that they have got a certain strength in terms of pushing. Top lane solo. He came out on this lane very, very far, and there will be three heroes on his case. Solo. Was looking, I guess, for the farm to finish off the Veil. I imagine he pretty much did find it, but...
Well, he was staying true to his name.
I mean, he was.
He was solo. But it's one of those things where sometimes you kind of have to take a risk to open up the map a little bit. And that's why people talk about, like, carry players all the time who play a riskier game because it forces rotations, makes people TP to towers, stuff like that.
Envy.
And I mean, just dying like that, even though obviously you don't want to die, it still gives information to the rescue team. So yeah, solo dies, but that means that FN and no one both have a really good idea of if they're safe or not, because they see how many heroes gank and they see who's there. So it's something that you see as an observer sometimes and you're kind of questioning why they were there, but you also have to think of it from the team perspective, which is, I got farmed for two cores by dying there.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's not like a total loss. Yeah.
Disability. Oh, might see a clash here. VP with the high ground, the ward up as well.
They're in a really good spot.
Vega hiding behind the tree line. Who's gonna pop first? Joker. Ooh. Oh, but they dropped the sentry, and here we go! The disruption hold. What about the Joker? He's already been taken out. Demon of the BKB pops down the Vengeful Spirit, but three dead on the side of BP. They'll find themselves a fourth, and Mike, that sentry.
What did he disrupt? What did the Shadow Demon disrupt?
I think he disrupted the Beastmaster. He had to try and stop Mag from getting off his spells.
That is so the wrong way to play that fight as Shadow Demon. Like, all he has to do is disrupt the jug as soon as that that fissure comes out, and he's 100% fine. That was a gigantic misplay by No Fear. There is no way that Juggernaut should have died, even though the sentry was clutch. Like, there's no doubt about that.
Oh, yeah, they should.
Like, dropping it and getting the stun in the first place was very nice. But if you disrupt that Juggernaut, they have zero damage on him, because as soon as he comes out, he spins. Yeah, they're going to get the Courier Snipe, but you can definitely tell that, you know, VP might not be playing Shadow Demon so much, because that was a very obvious disruption that was just straight up miss.
Yeah. And the thing as well is, you look at Vega's Knight, they didn't need to use Echo Slam for that one. They've still got the Aegis on FN. There's no reason to stop. There's no reason to put the brakes on. Keep going, Vega. We'll see how much more they can get. Tier 3 in the mid's going to drop. It'd be very nice for them to equalize the lane equilibrium here by getting this set of racks in return for what VP were able to claim earlier. The Sprout onto FN. G moving in, holds one back with the Astral. FN's going to go down once, but he's got that Aegis ready for round two. Meteor flying towards the Deafening Blasters as well, but it's not going to connect onto anyone. G pops the BKB, no messing around, leave for FN, but the swap, it's there. FN, he's going to be safe, but G chasing him down it. FN starts to try and turn it, pops the cooldown to hold back the rest of VP, but Yoku, Blade Fury's looking to continue the advance. The Fissure will hold back a little hard out time, no fear. Yoku, can he get himself in? But Mag jumps up, trying to chase down G, trying to keep the rest of his team alive solo, looking for the TP out from the sideline, actually cancels it, thinking about walking back in, but no. Oh, he's made a big mistake. Solo goes down. Maybe thinking about trying to find a turnaround Echo Slam there, but the rest of his team were already out of that. And meanwhile, FNG looking for a bit of the rat action on the top lane. But VP, they do hold, and they don't lose those rats in the mid lane.
That was, to be honest, they mitigated the disaster pretty well on the side of VP. Like, given the last fight, how badly it went for them, I think they got, what, 4-0'd or something? Lost a lot of heroes.
Oh, they did, yeah, 4 dead.
And that was with Vega having recently snuck the Aegis out from under them, so Vega doing all they can to try to claw their way back in. They do end up sieging the tier 3 and get the melee racks to about half, but ultimately not killing it, losing their Earthshaker and Venge in the process. So I think, honestly, that was still okay for Vega. The fact that they were able to get out on the map, apply some pressure, force VP back into their own base, that's the kind of stuff you need to do to make sure that you win. You can't just play defensive Dota the whole game.
And I mean, I think they're heeding to your advice, because Vega, they're looking for more. Smoking up again. They're not holding back. They want to try and find another successful fight.
It's going to be a good pick if they can find the jug.
Yeah, 20 seconds until that Omni's up as well for Yoku.
Mag's got Blink. And OD is nearby.
Yeah, if they can find this wraparound.
They have to go for G, I think. He can't go for the jug.
He's got to get a good roll, and he will. Jumps in. Yoku's going to be the focus. Meteor jumps well, but there's a disruption. They've also got an Astral from G if he wants to come back in and try and save Yoku. Yoku, Blade Fury. They're not going to be able to save the jug. Jug, he's going to go down. No fear try for the TP, but Vega chase it, find themselves a second. That is Gem on the deck as well. I'm sure Vega are aware. Oh, yes, Gem will see it now. So that's the Gem. Two kills. One of them, that high priority jug, who was sitting at the top of the board, and I think after that, you know, a close game is starting to tip in favor of Vega with these kind of fights.
Yeah, the smoke caught them off guard for sure. They had no idea it was coming. There's no aggressive vision except for in the... that is a top lane ward, but it's not going to see anything too crazy. I'm really surprised they actually got the kill that easily on the Juggernaut. I definitely underestimated how much damage they deal. The Jug's going for Ascati as well,
and
FN.
Top lane, indeed, FN. He gets himself out.
It's just a nice thing to do, you know. It's still a pretty long BKB duration. 8 to 7 second BKB. Definitely worth just by using a Rod of Atos charge. But this game's getting a little bit hairy for Virtus Pro. Would have been in a much better position if they just didn't lose that one Rosh. Like, so much happened because of that.
Oh, yeah.
They lose the team fight in the jungle. They end up getting their tier 3 taken down. They get pushed back on their side of the map. Everything in Dota is like a small butterfly effect, if you want to think about it that way. And obviously, the misplay on the disruption didn't help matters either. But Gyro's making his way towards Satanic. It's going to be huge. Not going for the damage build, going for the I want to live build. Which, considering how much damage the Invoker has been doing during these fights, like, no one's played a really solid game 2, and contrary to what he did in game 1 against Virtus Pro. Getting some good combos.
And I mean, talking about it, but what do you think he's going to go for next with that 5.5k save on him? Not a chance in hell.
He got the gem
the Shadow
off
Demon.
No fear as well. That
oh,
is painful.
Shoot. Nice stuff from Mag. And now Skirmer swapping him back to FNG. Getting the BKB off in time to dodge the magic missile damage and stun. And Skirmer, look at the TP. G walks in. They'll get him. They'll take one down. The question is, can they find anything more? Yoku playthrough. No one actually jumping up onto the high ground here. You have got the jar on the back. FN trying to go for it, but he just gets taken down there by the Omni Slash. Two dead on the side of Vega. And VP, they're trying to look for more. Fisher from solo holds back Yoku and G. And blink forward on the OD. He's trying to catch him out with a blink just in time from Shaker solo. Getting himself away from the grasp of that man. And of course, at the end of the day though, 2-for-1. VP with the favorable kills, but the Beastmaster, Mag, does manage to maintain control of that gem that he picks up from Nofit.
It's such a back and forth game because really neither team has a tremendous amount of vision. I suppose Vega have the advantage in that regard. They have two wards up right now. But every time you're playing with no vision against a Beastmaster, the team with the Beastmaster is always going to have just that slight edge in initiation. So Vega finding the picks, getting the important gem, that's going to be huge for them. I honestly still, anyone can take this. It's really just boiling down to who has the better control of the map, who gets the better jump. I'm not really feeling the Shadow Demon in the mid late game so much. I feel like No Fear is not necessarily in his comfort zone when you're talking about hero picks for him. Because I don't know if they've been running this a lot recently, but we certainly haven't seen it inside of Dream League. Like, I don't think I think this is the first game it's actually been played.
Yeah, that we've had here, certainly, yeah.
Now we'll see what else he can manage to do with this hero as time stretches on. But the rest of VP are still doing quite all right. You know, we're getting closer to Hex there on G. Scotty finished on the Jug. And the Gyro is still not doing a ton of damage, but I suppose the Beastmaster Aura and the Venge help out a lot in that regard. Like, Inner Beast with Vengeance is still quite a bit of DPS.
I guess eyes around the Roshan pit really next. It's about 1 minute until he's back up. Both teams would love to grab it. They certainly would like to grab a kill before that.
I think the Roshan fight might just decide the game,
yeah,
honestly. And they have vision, so they're going for No Fear.
Can't quite catch him there with the Tornado, though.
That should pretty much give away that there's a ward, too. Like, you don't blink high ground like that in Tornado unless you have vision. Like, there's no way. So, looking to see that get dewarded soon. Unfortunately, No Fear doesn't have his gem anymore, so FNG doing his sideline push thing. This is going to help a lot because it's going to make Vega eventually decide if they want to go for Roshan or if they want it back. So VP are scouting out Rosh while simultaneously pushing two lanes. Vega are actually not in a very good position right now because they're going to eventually have to leave. They can't just sit here and yeah, here they go. They're going to leave sooner, which is definitely the right call. You can't stick around in that situation. Otherwise, you end up in the spot where you have to pick between taking base damage or killing Rosh instead of just pushing out the lanes before the Rosh is up and then being able to contest without losing anything. So good call by Vega for backing up there. And Roshan's going to be spawning any second now. Vega needs to be very, very quick to get to this pit.
I really do, because it's going to go down so quickly.
Oh no, did it not see it? Okay, they pinged. Okay, they know. Okay. I wasn't sure if the Sunstrike vision faded, but
it must have been close.
Yeah, it was very close.
G, he's found himself a bit of action here, but Mac, to put the roar out. Magic Missile as well, but there's an Omni Slash flying through for Yoku and Mac.
Oh, the swap!
Oh, just save, but the Lightstrike will finish him. They've found Shoma as well, and this is a great start to play, but now FN coming in with the damage on the Black Cat, and it's so much to the end, that doesn't actually catch anyone. The Fissure of the two, the Meteor rolling through. Sanity is coming out from G, still alive. Mac fighting up against the rest of the side of Baker, and only no one surviving on the Invoker.
That echo was like the 10 cent echo. That actually did nothing.
And I think 10 cent going the way of VP as well.
Yeah. That was a brutal echo. All right, so Yoku ends the fight with 100% health. And unfortunately, the BKB duration from the gyro is getting a little bit lower now, and they just didn't have the damage and the coordination really inside of the team fight to take anyone down. I mean, yeah, you get the Lina, but big deal. Killing Aloha Dance at this stage in the game isn't really value. And as I was saying earlier, this Roshan is going to mean a ton. Not just because of the fact that, you know, they won the fight before that, but it's cheese. So now you're looking at FNG, 5,000 gold. G's got his Hex done, has Aegis. The power spike from VP right now is just enormous.
Really, really is. VP, let's see how much they can achieve with this one. You can see them ready to go for action on the bottom lane. The ping's coming out onto the bottom lane of Rax. They'd love to do something here. The full defense is going to be up for Vega. Echo Slam, how long's it on cooldown for? Let's have a look at the man. 55 seconds, of course, after that last fight. So they are going to be limited in that sense. The Fissure coming out, just trying to bide some time. Tornado catching out G. FNG just sprack G up, just in case anyone was going to come in with the slaps. VP, finding the tier 3 down to half health. Just keeping the vision there with that Sprouts. They could continue to pound away at the tower. We'll get it. MP forcing them back for a bit, but the healing ward's still up, and VP in full strength, ready to jump. Hex onto no one. The swap from Shadow being about, but he already got off the only side. Yoko don't get it. Yoko finds one with the blazer. He might just fight back. Back just gets himself out. Still struggling with Vanilla. Actually punish the jump's aggressiveness. Two buybacks coming out. Can Vega hold? No fear disrupting himself for the time being. G and FNG looking to get themselves out of the retreat. No fear should be punished. Jenny will. That's the gem going back the way of Vega. They've caught out G as well with a magic missile. Can they finish this one off? No one blinking forward. There'll be an Astral to buy some time for G, but they should be able to find this one, Vega, and they do. He's got the Aegis, round two. How's it looking? The odds for the man on the OD aren't going to be that great, and the stunt is there, the control coming out. He'll Astral himself again, just doing every thing he can to buy time. And what?
Nah, he's dead. Oh, he's dead.
Deafening blast to finish off that 6.86 BS. But
man,
my goodness.
Why were they diving so hard? Like, alright. If you're playing against a team and you get Roshan and you have cheese, if you slow siege, there's almost nothing Vega can do about it because their Shaker has to go in only when you engage. Like, how is he going to get a good echo if OD and Lina are just hitting the tower with the Furion? And then they dive to the well. Like, Yoku's right outside their well just gets wrecked and then forces the rest of the team in a horrible position. Yeah. I don't know why they dove. They could have slow siege. They had cheese still on FNG, and they could have just easily taken Rax.
I mean, it is, of course, there's going to be the buybacks on cooldown now for Vega. So if he goes for that again, you know, if they do get the similar kind of fight, because Vega aren't going to have those second lives, it's
but
still
going
to be good for them.
You can't go all in on a push like that and expect the enemy team to just not have buyout. Like, that's just such a YOLO play. Although, I guess it is CIS Dota, right? So.
There we have it. There you go. Now looking for their own push. FNG with the spout onto FN.
It hits really hard.
He just man finding up his showman. Look at the swap up, and now Yoku jumping in with the Omni Slash. Vega, they've got to be careful. Yoku. We'll blade through. He's going to be the one backing up at Light Strike. Connects onto no one. Mag jumps in. We're onto loadout. Fisher as well onto two. They'll punish the Lina. Lina's down. No buyback available.
Here.
Yeah, they've got to just be content with that one. The CFG blinks in and finds himself anything. Will blink forward. FNG getting the vision there with a Sprout, but the side of Vega. Pretty speedy on the retreat. They found FN. Tried for the TP out, but he's been hexed up. Solo's there. Jumped in. Echo's down. What to do? Now FN's got to turn around with the Black Cat. Kids can't get Steely Will. G's down. FNG as well. Vega doing it here on this high ground defense. Can they find themselves more? Blink forward from no one. Looking to control over there. He's trying to do as much as he can with the Soul Gate to the Shadow Pointer, but FN turns around with the Rocket Barrage. Will he live? He will. FN survives. They turn it around. VP losing four. And this time the solo Echo Slam was on point.
Yeah, that was a really good one. He timed it perfectly. I'm actually really amazed they were able to turn it so easily. Because did G just not have his BKB up? Because it's not on cooldown right now. I don't know what the heck happened. That was really strange. But yeah, counter racks coming in. They don't want to expend the buyback on either of their cores right now, but they're going to have to. Yeah, they have to buy back.
They've got to do something in VP, Vega.
Okay, there's no way they can let this go, right? Like, if G doesn't buy back, this Rax is dead.
Yoku's jumping in. Blade Fury onto Solo. There's your buyback now from G. Ice Ball will be dropped, but Yoku waltz is over there with the magic immunity. Now G popping the BKB, looking forward to moving for more Solo. Oh! He got the blink out! Solo escapes! Laguna will be there to finish off the Evoker, and that is him dead for a good 2 minutes. No buyback available on this man. Vega, they need to win this fight, but they've lost the second. Showman falling as well in the Vengeful Spirit.
They're gonna run straight bottom, yeah. They need to go, or they can go through mid as well if they want. They can push out the lane and just
this
try to go
the
for the Rax.
No Invoker for 100 seconds. VP.
No one has bots, though. So they have to walk all the way across the map, which is going to take a little while. And
nice
Echo is actually up in 15. So a good Echo Slam, if VP get overconfident and start like grouping up, Solo can definitely defend with a Gyro if they give him the opportunity for an Echo. They need to be very conscious of that.
This is a huge window for the side of Virtus Pro. They've just not got to fluff it up. If Mag can set up Aurora into a nice Echo Slam, but no, that's set up onto him. Jumping in with a Hex and Mag's gone. Does have a buyback available, will get himself straight in, and there's your Echo Slam. Catching out G and no fear. G pops the BKP, FN. Has he got the damage to deal enough against his OD? He might just, but no, G pops the G. Laguna back onto FN. That's your Gyro down. Mag as well on a dive back on the Beastmaster. There's a buyback from Solo, but he's the only man left standing at the moment for the side of Vega Squadron, and this could be GG. VP now looking to clean up the rest of these racks on the top lane. Is it going to be a two-man defense from Vega? They've got that Echo Slam. Can he do anything big with it? He's going to need a miracle.
He sold all his items and bought a refresher.
Okay. I mean, why not? Last pitch attempt.
All right, let's do it.
They're not going to expect
let's
it.
Go.
They're not going to expect it, VP. If Solo can land this, this could be an insane play from the man.
I don't know, man. They're megas. I don't know if it makes.
If he can do something insane with this Echo, he's waiting for the perfect Echo. He really is. 10 seconds, there it is. Jumps in, catches four, and focus back in 10, but the mech comes out from VP. Now with the right click, the Monkey King bar from Effigy doing so much work. He is down as well.
There we go, GG.
It was an admirable attempt there with the sell all items and buy a refresh before all else fails.
That was the most YOLO play, but, you know, if they had anyone else in buyback, I think it might have actually worked.
I mean, as well, we saw at the end, no one was so close to being back alive, and he just ended the game being the only one back on the map. If that was any sooner, and he could follow up that Echo Slam, maybe, just maybe, Vega could have held him. But 46 minutes in, 34-39, VP take the game, take the series, of course, 2-0. I mean, what a game, Andy. That's going to be one of the best we've had this Dream League.
It was much closer than the first game, but I still feel like VP could have had a